And now it's time for some things in the news that caught my eye. And this story in the Smithsonian was fascinating about U.S. copyright law. So for the first time in 20 years, we're going to see some copyrighted works enter the public domain. Basically, any works that were produced in 1923 are in the public domain as of today. So you can go download some album that was made in 1923 and put it on your YouTube channel or republish it, whatever you want to do. That stuff now belongs to everyone, not just the original creators of that work. It's based on how copyright law existed at the time that those works were created, and that stuff is now out there. But the last time things got released to the public domain was actually 20 years ago. So in 1998, works from 1922 entered the public domain, and you would think that every year after that we should see things happen, and that was how it was supposed to work. But of course, the mouse got involved, Mickey Mouse, because Disney, a very large entertainment corporation that's even larger today than it was 20 years ago, is very concerned that Mickey Mouse is nearing that point in which he may become part of the public domain and no longer exclusively under Disney's control. And what happened was is they got behind the Sonny Bono Copyright Term Extension Act, again in 1998, that made some changes to copyright law. The first thing is that it adjusted a 1976 copyright law to extend how long a work is copyrighted for. Now, initially, there was just a time stamp on the life of the author plus a certain number of years. They extended that number of year extension from 50 years to 75 years in that extension act. They also said that works of corporate authorship will enjoy a 120-year copyright. So if, for example, Disney makes some new intellectual property as of 1998 moving forward, that will have a 120-year copyright before it enters public domain. So if you are a corporation, you get a longer length of copyright perhaps than you would based on the lifespan of the author. And the Sonny Bono Act also changed how older content would be released to the public domain. So for things made before 1978, it used to be that you had 75 years from the time the item was first published. They moved that from 75 to 95 years. That essentially put the pause button on everything, including the release of Mickey Mouse into the public domain. But now we're getting to the point where this extension has extended, and now we've got Mickey Mouse once again on the copyright chopping block. Steamboat Willie could be public domain in 2023 if Disney doesn't take action, and no doubt they will take action at some point in the near future. So I think you can expect more of this copyright adjustment as we get closer to that year. Disney certainly is a much larger company now. They've got a lot of influence in Congress here in the United States, and I'm sure they will be doing something to preserve their mark. And it also speaks to how popular culture is changing as well. I think back to the fact that they're still making Star Wars movies almost 40 years later. When I was a kid, there wasn't much that I watched that my parents were into, maybe Superman and a few comic books and whatnot. But generally, you know, things were new to us in the 70s and 80s, I think, more so than we're seeing today, which is mostly rehashing old IP. And I think this is clearly something that Disney is going to be concerned about. And I would expect the mouse to be making sure he doesn't get released to the public anytime soon. So be sure to not post Steamboat Willie on your YouTube channel until at least 2023. But I predict we'll have another extension of the copyright law to prevent that from happening. And if you want to see just how much influence Mickey Mouse has had in U.S. copyright law, check out this neat article at the Art Law Journal that gives a really cool timeline of everything that has transpired with the mouse over the years.
This channel is brought to you by the Lon.TV supporters, including gold-level supporters Chris Allegretta, the Four Guys with Quarters podcast, Tom Albrecht, and Kalyan Kumar. If you want to help the channel, you can by contributing as little as a dollar a month. Head over to lon.tv/support to learn more. And don't forget to subscribe. Visit lon.tv/s.